Hey everyone, so I'm back for another retro repair video, this time for a CD player. So I've been looking for a CD player for my wife's stereo setup in the living room. I've been looking for one for a while now. And we were out retro hunting over the weekend, and we went to a shop that we often go to, and they had one that caught my eye there, a nice Pioneer. And it's a 6-disc changer. It's really cool. It's got this cartridge that pops out instead of having your traditional tray or the big tray that has all the discs that go around. This is a cartridge that pops out, and you put your 6 discs in there and it shuffles through them. So the whole thing completely comes out. It's really cool. So I really kind of liked it. So the guy didn't know if it worked or not. So he gave it to me for a really good price. And I figured it was worth the gamble for the price that he sold it to me for. So sure enough, I get home and it doesn't work. It seems to be working mechanically, but it wasn't reading anything. So it would just shuffle through, you know, if you had a disc in the compartment, it just would skip it as if it wasn't in there. So I was like, okay, I guess that's my next repair project. So I'm gonna do this narration style because I recorded this in my kitchen. There was all kind of people and noises around. So I'll be cutting some videos into this. So I took it apart. Wasn't that difficult to take apart. It's like 6 screws. And I just kind of gave it a visual inspection. This is a 1987 CD player. And this thing looked beautiful inside. It was very clean, no dust, no cigarette grime. It was in very good condition. So I looked at everything kind of visually. Didn't notice anything that caught my eye, looking for a broken belt or something. But kind of my intuition was telling me it has something to do with the laser, the lens or whatever. So I took the little reader part off, and sure enough, the lens was missing. It wasn't even on there. So I tilted the unit over, and the lens just slid down and clunk, hit the side of the inside of the unit. So I picked it up and I looked at it, and it had been glued in. So I took some super glue and a little paintbrush, and I very carefully applied some glue back on the little area where that lens went, and just put the lens back in and let it dry for a couple of hours. And I put it back together, and without hooking it up, I wanted to see if it was going to read. And sure enough, it started reading the disc, and I was like, yes, it worked. So I set the stereo up, and I'll cut a video in here of me trying it for the first time. All right, guys, this is the true test. It showed that the disc was reading, but I got it all hooked up, and we're going to check it out. I got 3 discs loaded up in this thing. This is such a cool design. I really like this cartridge. You load the 6 discs in there, and you take the whole thing and you plug it in like this. And let's see here, CD. Let's see what happens here. Try another disc. Let's go to 3. Hit play. Some crung bin. Great CD. Try the first disc. That would be Queen. So happy this is working.
It's a kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. A kind of magic. One dream, one soul. One prize, one golden glass.
That's a win.
Of what?
So as you can see, my wife has a very nice setup now with a nice receiver, nice speakers, a nice CD player, and a nice record player. I don't think she's going to go for tapes. I do like collecting cassette tapes, and I listen to them here in my room, but I don't think she has much interest in that. So I think she is fully set up now, which I'm really excited about. All these components I got at retro shops, they're all vintage, and they're all, and you know, I made some repairs to them, obviously, and cleaned them up real good. But it just goes to show you can get stuff really cheap. And a lot of times these things are not very difficult to fix. A lot of times they're simple things like broken belts, maybe even broken gears that you can get offline. In this case, it was a little lens that just fell off and I just was able to glue it back on. Obviously my TV here was a lot more extensive, which is why it was four parts. And this one's just one small part, thankfully. I didn't want it to be a big project, but I was very thankful that I was able to get it for a good price and get it fixed up the same weekend that I picked it up. So it's really cool to have that now in the living room, all working good and sounding good. And my wife now can expand her hunting, not just for records, but for CDs now. Because sometimes, you know, you can't find the record that you want, and you can get a CD and have a CD collection as well. So that is it. I know this was a quick one, but I figured I'd document my repair and throw it on the YouTube channel for you guys to watch. So thanks, and I'll see you next time.